This is JS with Movie Clips, here with a review of After Tiller. After Tiller is an intimate look into the abortion clinics, specifically those that deal with late-term abortions, some that even take place in the third trimester. The title refers to this scene in recent years, because in 2009, Dr. George Tiller was murdered by an anti-abortion extremist. The doctors and nurses on display are saddened from the very beginning, partly because they knew Tiller, some even studied over his shoulder. Others are in fear for their lives and the lives of their family, but mostly because day in and day out, they have expectant mothers coming into their clinics who, for one reason or another, have found themselves at this point in their life. Filmmakers Martha Shane and Lena Wilson bring us this dwelling documentary that focuses on the people that so many of us have painted a horn and tails on in our mind's eye. In reality, they are caring, thoughtful, and ordinary-looking people. Their patients are captured carefully. We never see their faces so as to respect their privacy, but the lens instead focuses upon Kleenex-clutching hands that are held over protruding bellies. One mother with a very sick baby inside points out, "I feel guilt no matter which way I go." Late-term abortions are among the more controversial of the pact. The fetus is more developed and in some cases viable. I feel all of this actually makes it all the more heart-wrenching. These mothers, in many cases, were planning on their babies to be born. Some, after heart-racking torment and months of denial, have come to this point as a sort of last resort. In one instance, we have a 16-year-old girl, and as the doctor points out to her, "You have choices, but they all suck." No matter your stance on abortion, this documentary is worth your time and your consideration. It's not entirely fair and balanced, and that's nigh near impossible to do with such a hot topic as this. Scenes of protesters and church assembling crowds are set to menacing music. There's even a canted angle of a red neon crucifix at one point. But it does show us into the lives of people inside the clinic and sometimes the glimpses of those outside. Filmmaking is always manipulative, and here it's employed to derive sympathy for the abortion providers and their patients, and to more or less vilify those who oppose. The film puts its best foot forward when it merely observes those who oppose, those on the outside holding signs, saying prayers, and trying to talk women out as they walk towards a clinic's door. There's one man who's outside holding a sign that says, "Men regret lost fatherhood." Even though he's seen from afar, I seem to think that he's holding that out of personal experience. While it's often placed in one of two camps, After Tiller further pressed upon my mind that this is far from a black and white issue, and for that, it remains a must-see documentary. After Tiller has been racing around on the festival circuit, and in the coming months, it will be released in select cities. Seek this movie out wherever possible. On the movie clip scale, I give After Tiller a 90 out of 100. It's not entirely fair and balanced, but this is a searing and intimate, often poignant look into the lives of those involved. This is one of the few films this year that I would encourage everyone I meet to see. For Movie Clips, this is JS. Thanks for watching.